Back with Ryan Borowski, Gary Griffith at Dugshall Stadium in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, ready for this practice. It's the juniors up first and the North versus the South squad. And in fact, that will be the case at 7 o'clock. It'll be the North versus the South also.
These kids from all over the country. And again, this is a practice. So what will happen is you'll see 25 plays from the 20-yard line, and then 25 plays from the 20-yard line for the North and then the South. And then they'll do it from the 50-yard line. And then they'll finish it off with some red zone offense and defense as well. We'll keep you posted as it goes on, keep you into it, and keep you updated on what is about to happen. But again, 25 plays, quality reps for both of these teams. And again, this is the junior practice. We have some big boys out there ready to play some football and hit hard today.
All right, they'll tee it up. The North will have it first. Here's the first play from scrimmage for the North. Dropping back, the quarterback, Cory Brandon, looking upfield. Pass in the air, incomplete. Looking downfield for Rhett Adley. Rhett out of Lexington High School. That's Lexington, Massachusetts.
And that time the North come out in a pistol formation. We haven't seen that a lot. Usually it's been the basic spread formation. Again, these kids haven't been together for a long time, a little less than a week, so it's tough to implement an offense. But with all the skill out there on this field, usually it can compensate for the lack of preparation.
Receivers left and right going up to the top of the screen. We'll take a look at Robert Brisbois. And coming down to the bottom, one of those is the tight end. And that's Liam Haime. He's out of Canada, the quarterback. Working from the shotgun is Brandon. He'll give to his running back coming out of the backfield. He'll pick up about 2 or 3 yards, and we'll take a first look at that young man as he gets off the ground. That's Khalil Fleming, running back out of Penn High School in Indiana.
And one thing I did want to mention is you can't send some of the other rules that we were talking about in stipulations. You can't send more than 6 players on a blitz. And also, the offensive lineman can't do any twists, stunts, or anything along that line. So, yes, it'll make it difficult for some of these running backs, but it's just something that has to go along with the practice, the rules, and the regulations.
Now, as we mentioned yesterday, that there could easily be some players that we can't identify. They change jerseys a lot at the last minute. From an I-back formation, back in the pocket, looking downfield, pass in the air, intercepted by the South, intercepted by Caleb Smith. And he'll take it in, so that didn't take long.
Well, we talked about Caleb Smith in the pregame show, 6 feet, 180, a DB out of Alabama. He's physical. He didn't really need his tight man coverage right there. The ball really came right to him. What I like to see with these juniors, and we saw it on the bottom of the screen before, if you look on the North squad, number 5, Robert Brisbois, he was getting pressed at the bottom of the screen, a good release by him. And he actually had a step on his DB down here, but the quarterback didn't see him. So it'll be nice to see these kids play physical. And again, that's Caleb Smith cashing in on the interception.
Well, as the rules stipulate, even though it's an interception, the ball goes right back to the North. They bring it right back out to the 20, and they have 3 receivers on the short side. In fact, they've got 5 receivers and an empty backfield. The quarterback, Cory Brandon, sends a man in motion, and he's going to give to that man going from right to left. That's Rhett Adley again. Adley picks up about 5 yards, takes a hard hit, and they'll try it again.
And on the hard hit, I believe that was number 36, Elijah Tamarki. That was an unbelievable hit coming up from the outside linebacker position and really just putting a stop to that play. Like you said, about 4 yards, if that. Great hit, great form tackle, which we're going to look out for a lot today here with these old upperclassmen.
Elijah Tamarki, I love the school he's from. He's from Copperas Cove High School in Texas. Checking in for the first time, Derek Giesner out of Forest Lake High School in Minnesota. He's a receiver. And on the right hash mark, the North is ready from the shotgun. Long count here by Brandon. Takes a snap, drops it, and he's going to go down. Coming in to finish him off, Chevelle Smith. Smith from Russell County, Alabama.
Talked about Chris Redman. He's a D lineman, 6 feet, 345 pounds, big number 53 out there. And we talked about they didn't have a lot of preparation coming into this game, but they are mixing up the coverages. That time they had Redman drop back from his D tackle position and actually go into coverage. You see that a few times with the Packers do that with BJ Raji in the NFL. That's interesting, an interesting move right there, and it would have been tough for the quarterback to adjust to. You're not expecting that.
From their own 20-yard line, the North breaks the huddle. Staying in at quarterback, Cory Brandon. Of course, we'll probably see several different quarterbacks during this practice. from the shotgun. Now, he does have a running back behind him and receivers going in motion left to right, Brett Adley. But it won't make any difference as coming in to drop the quarterback quickly. That's Keith Gordon out of Etowah High School down in Georgia. I mean, he was in the backfield before Brandon could react.
Yeah, nobody accounted for him. He got there, and there he got in there quick. But the best part about it is he wrapped up the running back and he took him down. It's one thing to have a big hit. It's another thing to actually take him down to the ground. Great play right there by the South's defense.
And again, from the 20, I believe they get 25 offensive plays. Is that what we said?
25 plays, so you have to figure they have about 18. Say they ran about six so far.
Once again, an empty backfield. And this time, the quarterback, Corey Brandon, turns around and I think he wants to make sure he knows where that defensive player is that just sacked him a moment ago. The snap to Brandon. Blitz shown again. Quick screen pass out to the right, complete, pickup of about 1 yard. And again, it's going to be Rhett Adley who made the catch. So the South in the maroon uniforms, Ryan, certainly taking this very seriously. They were showing blitz once again.
This defense looks good, and we have some players highlighted up here, and almost all of them for the South are defensive players. When you look out there at number 44 on Caleb Smith, and like I said, Chris Redman out of Ridgeview, South Carolina. The size, the speed with this South defense, it's going to be tough for this North defense to overcome, and they're struggling with it right now on a third and long.
Well, it's a third down for the North. They don't seem to be picking up much ground. Now they're back at their 15, a long count once again by Brandon. Three-step drop, plenty of time. Now he's going to keep it and come out and slide down at the 21-yard line right before he ran into Chevelle Smith. Again, Smith made a sack a moment ago. And again, we'll reiterate as we go along, there are a certain amount of plays, and we'll try to keep a running total, but that's not the end of the world. We know they get approximately 25 plays. Not total, but from the 20.
It looks like there was a penalty on the play as well, a personal foul, so it'll move the North team up. They came out in five wide receivers set, and they had the slot man open. It was Adley, who's a running back, but he was in the slot position. He was wide open, but he ended up running a corner route, which took him right into the coverage. If he just settled up in the zone, he would have had at least a 20-yard catch plus room to run with his athletic ability.
Justice Breedlove has just checked in to be a receiver. In fact, three receivers on one side, and one looks like he's unattended. So somebody needs to cover one of these receivers from the shotgun. Again, the snap to the new quarterback, Sebastian Bell. Bell up across the 40 to the 42-yard line. Sebastian Bell out of Kelvin High School in Manitoba. So we have some young men here from Canada.
Yeah, we have players from Texas, Florida, Canada, California, Minnesota we had yesterday in the youth game. It's good to get them all together. And again, they're on their Christmas break. So for them to come together and compete here at Doug Shaw Stadium in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, is not only fun for them, but fun for us, fun for everybody who's involved in this entire practice.
North has it in the middle of the field at their 42-yard line. They send receivers left and right and keep one running back in the backfield. That's Derek Giesner. And the quarterback still in there now is Sebastian Bell. Bell working from the shotgun, second quarterback used already. He's going to keep it himself. Big hole on the left side. Stiff arms one defender and picks up 3 yards. He put a move on Elijah Tomarki. Tomarki already with one big tackle on this practice, but a nice stiff arm there on Tomarki.
Well, and a big pop taken down towards the bottom of the screen by Izakoli from California. We talked about him in the pregame. He's a great talent out there. Number 15 in the maroon. I don't know if we have a shot of him right now, but he's physical. He loves to press up at the line. He's been doing it so far. Like we've said, coachable, humble, team-oriented, and he's willing to work on his weakness. And right now you can tell his weakness is not hitting. He loves to do that.
New player into the ball game. That's Nabiel Hussain. He's a receiver at the top of your screen. Again, from the shotgun with a running back. Draw play given. And Adley might make it back to the line of scrimmage. Check it. That's going to be Maxwell Sorby. Sorby out of Warren Township High School in Illinois.
Not a lot of running room in between the tackles on that play, plus a flag. It'll be a holding call on the North, so that'll bump him back about 10 yards, set him up for a second and long.
So they mark it off back to the north 41-yard line. And they'll tee it up again. They break the huddle. And coming down to the near side, that's going to be Robert Brisbois, who checked in a moment ago. Three receivers up top.
And here's the pressing going on at the bottom of the screen. You can see it perfectly. Great shot from our cameraman.
And again, the quarterback staying in there, Sebastian Bell, takes a snap, drops back under pressure, looks downfield, pass in the air, knocked down. Coming in at the last minute, Markel King out of Overhills High School in North Carolina. Overhills High School in North Carolina. Good defensive back, knocked that play down. Another flag there, Ryan.
And I'm not sure what the flag might have been. It could have been a pass interference call because it's right by where the coverage was. And it will be holding on the defense. They're going to say that it was Izakoli getting a little bit too aggressive down at the bottom of the screen. So holding it will move them up just a bit and put them in a good position on this down and distance right here. But that's a perfect example. Pressing towards the bottom of the screen that you guys saw. He got by it by about 4 or 5 inches. The safety did a great job getting over the top and covering for the cornerback towards the bottom of the screen. I didn't see the penalty, but I guess the referees did.
So the North is in South territory for the first time in this practice at the South 49-yard line. And again, receivers three up top. And the safety has to drop about 20 yards off the line. Quarterback, Sebastian Bell, looks up and down the line, into his count, ready. Three-man rush, pass in the air, looking downfield for Robert Brisbois. Brisbois makes a catch, but he's out of bounds.
Yeah, and it's the same exact two safeties over the top. And the cornerback knows he has some help, so he can't afford to press it to the line, and he also can give up a few feet. And that time he did, but the quarterback just threw it out of bounds.
There's Brisbois coming back to the huddle. Robert Brisbois from Hudson High School in Massachusetts. Brisbois will again be a receiver down to the short side of the field. And another lone running back in the backfield. That's Cory Brandon, who started actually as the quarterback here for the North. And now is a running back standing behind the quarterback, Sebastian Bell. Blitz is shown. It's picked up. Bell's going to come on the left side, the 40 down to the 38-yard line, and finally pushed out of bounds by Markel King.
And that's a beautiful run right there. Get the first down, know where the sticks are, and get out of bounds. Save yourself from the hit. Also, the slot receiver, I said it a few times, if they run that same formation, there's nobody accounting for that slot receiver. It's an automatic 10 yards every single time. We'll see if the defense can adjust to that. But again, a good run for a first down.
So the North and the in-South territory at the South 38-yard line on the left hash mark.
And there it is, the three receivers at the top, but only two defensive backs covering.
Yeah, that's been a consistent blown assignment so far. Somebody's going to be open.
They'll sneak the outside linebacker out now.
And safety's going to have to drop over from the top. Instead of quarterback keeper, Sebastian Bell is going to be forced out of bounds. I think what they're doing defensively is taking one of those safeties up on the top. And eventually, once the ball is snapped, one of those safeties has to pick up one of those extra receivers because I'm seeing the same formation you're seeing, three receivers and only two defenders.
Yeah, well, that time they snuck the outside linebacker out there. I'm not positive who it was for the South team, but they snuck him out there. They cheated safety over the top, but when you see the outside linebacker come on the blitz, that's the thing. When these teams don't have a lot of chemistry because they're just meeting each other now, that'll be the 25 plays for the North team. But without the chemistry, you don't really have a hot read. You would do that normally throughout their high school year. You would say hot read. You would have communication with the slot receiver when they send that blitz. But, of course, in these games, you're not looking to nickel and dime people. You want to make the big play in these practices, and you want to get better at everything that you're doing.
So the South sends out Dimitri Leverett, quarterback out of Bartow, Florida. And here comes the South from their 20. Quick pass over on the left side, right in the hands of the receiver, but he dropped the ball. And I believe that was Keith Gordon over there who had the catch. Check it. That Jonte Ganton out of Montebello High School in Colorado. And what's the old cliche? If it hits you in the hands, you should catch it?
Yeah, that's what they say. And Leverett is, like you said, from Florida, wearing the Florida Gator colors out there, you'd have to assume. Not sure if that's just his high school colors or if he is a Gators fan also. It looks a little bit like RG3 as you see the close-up right there with the hair flowing out of the helmet.
And somebody jumped offside there for the North. Tyree Tomlinson may be the guilty party. And they are going to call even though this is a practice, they're going to call the penalties. Obviously, we had some earlier when the North had their first offensive drive. The South breaks the huddle, and their quarterback is Dimitri Leverett. He'll keep a running back behind him. That's Tyler Bettinger out of Barbers Hill, Texas. And it's a quarterback keeper by Leverett. Room around the left side up to the 40 to the 45. Almost made it to midfield.
Well, that's exactly what I wanted to see right there. Leverett, we know he can run the ball, but I want to see if that young man can sit back and sling it as well. So great run by Leverett, but let's see him throw it in the pocket. There are some open receivers down the bottom of the screen. Same exact thing, two defensive backs on three receivers. We'll see how the South can adjust to that.
So a first down for the South. They have it first and 10 at their left hash mark at their own 48-yard line. Again, receivers left and right, kind of a high snap, pitch backs. Going to go to the running back coming out of the backfield. That's Jarrett Inkst, I might say, out of St. Christopher's High School in Virginia. And he takes it into North Territory to the South. Starting at their own 20, Ryan, they're already at the North 46-yard line.
And you can tell the South team has a lot of speed on that edge. It looked like the running back was caught dead in his tracks, but he shows some speed around the end. Again, that was number 42 for the South. Jarrett Mitchell, we talked about him, a California kid.
Man in motion, high snap, pass, looking way downfield, open receiver, pass in and out of the hands. Trying to pick up who that receiver is. This might be the case. Yep, that's Theo Mordecai. Mordecai was open. The pass was there. He just simply dropped it.
And you can't throw that ball any better. He had the man. He beat him over the top, and that was a great throw by Leverett. Just went in and out of the hands. You know you'd like to have that one back. Talented receiver, though, up there. Good job creating some separation.
Dimitri Leverett, the quarterback, looking over toward the sideline to get a play. Now, during this practice, I'm assuming those are coaches who are on the field kind of helping out. The man who just dropped that pass, Mordecai, at the top of your screen with a slot receiver beside him. Quarterback remains Leverett. In the backfield now is Gannon Hinks. He's on the right side of the quarterback. The give is going to be to Hinks. Nope, it's a quarterback keeper by Leverett. Shakes off one tackle, 40 down to the 36-yard line. Finally brought down by Alonzo Regna.
Good aggressive running right there by Leverett. Takes one hit, yards after contact. That's what you look for, especially in a high school quarterback where you might run a little bit more than, say, in the college and pro level. Great run right there. First down, and the South team's moving the ball right now. The North needs to come up with an answer again. 25 plays for each team. We've seen the North run their 25 plays. Now it's up to the South to run their 25. They've probably ran about, I would say, six or seven so far.
All right, the South breaks the huddle. The man up top, that's going to be Theo Mordecai coming down to the short side of the field. One of those is Jonte Gatson. Now Gatson being sent in motion from right to left. He'll get set before the play takes off. The quarterback, Dimitri Leverett, having to tie his shoe. Now in motion left to right. Here comes Gatson back. High snap. Pass downfield looking for the intended receiver, and he was looking for Markell Jones. I believe it was intercepted. It was, so the interception down there by the North. And I believe
that was number 45, Elijah Allison. You can't have that. You're moving the ball. He's from Missouri, I believe. That's a great interception right there. Throws it up for grabs. When you're moving the ball that well, it's not really necessary to throw that ball up like that. The South, good part about this practice is that they're going to have an opportunity to come back, prove themselves once again. Good drive by Leverett. Just that throw at the end was the one thing. The only thing he did bad on that drive. He's a talented quarterback.
So they walk back to the 20. They'll try it again. The South has the football. The quarterback so far up to this point has been Dimitri Leverett out of Bartow High School in Florida, and is adorned, as you noted, with a helmet that looks like a Florida Gator helmet.
And he has excellent overall throwing mechanics with a quick flick of the wrist, what we saw right there. And they said he may have the best arm strength of all of the junior players out here as well. He's got excellent speed, making him a dual threat to score with his legs and also his arm as well.
Snap to Leverett, going to keep it himself, trying to get something on the left side, but he won't find much. Maybe a yard, not much more than that, coming in to make the tackle for the North. Looked like it was Maxwell Sorby who led the way. Now the South besides Leverett, looking down their roster, they have one, two, three other quarterbacks. Grant Hanman is one. The other two, Jacob Roddenberry, and then Tyler Swafford. Now, whether we're going to see them, those players or not, I don't know. Leverett remains in the backfield as a quarterback for the moment for the South. And before he can take the snap, Ryan, we have a stoppage.
Yeah, it'll be a false start penalty. I didn't see it, but I guess they're talking to one of the linemen about when they were going down in their stance. So that'll push him back about 5 yards. Again, this is a practice, but we still have the officials out here calling these penalties as well.
Well, they mark off the penalty. You can still see the sunshine very evident on the field, but the shadows are lengthening. And pretty soon, of course, evening will descend here in Myrtle Beach and engulf Dougshaw Stadium. They already have the lights on. All right, from their own 12-yard line, here's the South ready. Leverett rolling to his right. Nobody's open. He's going to tuck it in and make it up across the 15 to the 16-yard line. Coming in to make the tackle. And I've got one of those players. I'm having a hard time finding his number on the roster, but I believe it's Liam Haime.
Well, and on that play, you'll see Leverett running or scrambling out to his right. He had to escape the pocket, and the three receivers towards the bottom of the screen all ran hitch patterns at about 5 yards. What you'll learn as you get through your high school career is scramble patterns. They'll be the same whether you're playing for this team or whether you're playing for the New York Giants. If you're a shallow route, you go deep. If you're deep, you come in, but nothing happened on that play.
Receivers left and right, three on the top side of the field. Here's a quarterback keeper by Leverett again. Great coverage defensively, and Leverett recognizing this. So he keeps the ball and picks up 3 yards. Now, I'm beginning to wonder, since this is a practice, we've noticed both the North and the South in a certain formation will have three receivers, but only two seem to be covered. Now, I'm wondering if that's by design so that the safeties can practice working on coming into a proper coverage.
It could be. They are dropping over, and like I said, cheating towards that side. But again, now you'll have the regular spread formation with two wide receivers on each side, so this play right here is kind of an exception. But again, a false start penalty, so this will make it a third and very long for both teams, or for the South, I should say.
Joe Evans now in the backfield for the South. Evans from Riverside Durham High School in North Carolina. That is in Durham, North Carolina. Another penalty. I'll tell you what, this might be a practice, but they're calling the penalties very tight.
Also wanted to point out number 57, Jalen Nash, a linebacker out of North Carolina. He's a physical guy. He has great cover skills as well in the white out there, actually in the green socks.
Snap, and the give is to Evans, the man I just mentioned out of Riverside High School in Durham, North Carolina. He takes it up across the 20 to the 22. And again, we're not really keeping a running tab, but they get 25 plays from scrimmage beginning at the 10-yard line. I'm going to say this is about play number 10 or 12.
How do you feel about Nash's green socks out there? Maybe we'll get the camera guys to get a shot of him. He's a great linebacker, and we've seen him step up in the run game. I'd like to see him in coverage, too. We were told that he's a great cover linebacker.
Jalen Nash with those green socks from East Gaston High School in Gaston County, North Carolina, not too far from Charlotte. And the give once again to Joel Evans. Evans picked up 2 or 3 yards. Now the young man with those green socks, that would be Jalen Nash.
And there they are.
There they are.
You'll see that yesterday we saw a lot of kids spatting their cleats and doing a lot of things, you know, look good, feel good, play good, the Oregon mentality. And he even comes out, Oregon had those type of neon colors when they played Auburn in the national championship. So, again, that's Jalen Nash, junior linebacker out of Mount Hiley, North Carolina. 6'1", 245, a big guy right there rushing the edge.
From their own 21-yard line, the South is ready. And the quarterback remains Dimitri Leverett. He takes a snap, quick drop, pass complete, left side to Jonte Gadsden. Gadsden runs across, runs out of bounds at the 35-yard line, just shy of the 35, and unfortunately takes out one of the people holding the chains over there.
Yeah, he took out a few people, even a few players on the North roster. Again, now they'll have, I believe it'll be a first down when they mark it. Chains even bent over there. That's how hard the hit was.
Again, on the South, there are four quarterbacks on the roster, but up to this point, we've only seen Dimitri Leverett compared to when the North had the football. We saw several quarterbacks run the show for them. Leverett still in there working from the shotgun. And receivers, again, left and right. Man-to-man coverage down at the bottom of your screen. And a long count here by Everett. Now it seems to be some confusion.
Well, they're trying to fix that chain over there. It was a first down, so they moved the chains up. But the front chain is actually right now. Took a big shot. There's a few players that went over there. And that chain guy is pretty tough. He came up. And see, as you can tell from our great shot right there, that is...
Well, they're trying to fix that chain as best as
hopefully
they can.
Hopefully the chain doesn't come out of our paychecks.
All right, from their own 29-yard line, here comes the South. From the shotgun, Leverett, long count, blitz shown, high snap. He keeps it, dumps off a screen pass up to the 38-yard line to Jonte Gadsden. Gadsden makes it to the 39. And right now, Gadsden becoming a favorite target of Leverett. Although earlier, Ryan, there was a great pass downfield to Theo Mordecai, about a 30-yard pass, and Mordecai just simply dropped the ball.
Well, that is a great play by Leverett right there. We talked about it yesterday, these quarterbacks. Yes, it's good to stand in the pocket. Yes, it's good to make your reads, progressions, and have the correct throw. But all good quarterbacks, all great quarterbacks know how to improv. That's what he did right there.
Another high snap. Quarterback, keeper by Dimitri Leverett. Looked like Leverett wanted to give it to Joel Evans coming out of the backfield. Well, we talked about this yesterday. These players have had a little bit of time to work with each other, but we noticed quite a bit of problem on the exchange yesterday between the centers and the quarterbacks. It's almost to be expected because, stating the obvious, they haven't worked with each other throughout the season.
Haven't worked with each other, and that a lot of the stuff, especially in the spread, the perimeter offense, is when you're getting the running back and the quarterback on the move read options, are all about chemistry, and that's really the exchange has been the biggest problem. But we haven't seen much of it today.
Leverett takes a snap, rolling to his right, open man up the field, had a receiver open and overthrows Tyler Bettinger. Well, one thing about Leverett, we've already seen him successfully complete a couple of screen passes. But twice, he's demonstrated that he can throw at least about a 35, 40, or 50-yard pass downfield.
Well, they said he's probably got one of the best arms out of all the juniors here in this practice today. And he had his receiver open, missed him by about a step. Good route on the bottom of the screen, and a good job finding the zone. Lever just put a little bit too much mustard on that. If not, he might have still been running. Keep it here, and now we'll go back to the 50-yard line. And just to get you caught up on what we were just saw, 25 plays for each team from the 20-yard line. Now they go to midfield, and they get 25 plays, starting with the north. So they'll have the four-down sequence. If they don't get it in four downs, if they don't move the chains, if they don't bring it down towards the end zone, then they bring it right back to the 50-yard line. Again, 25 plays for each team from where we are right now. After this, both teams will have an opportunity to work on their red zone offense and defense.
All right, you heard that explanation from Mr. Ryan Borowski. We almost have to keep up the rules as much as what transpires on the field during this practice. Now, at 7 o'clock tonight, the seniors will take Duckshaw Stadium for a game.
And I'm looking forward to that game. It'll be a regular game. I'm not sure if it's 12 or 15-minute quarters yet, what they decided on, but that'll be good. A lot of talented kids, and we've seen our stat sheet already. We have the roster with their stats and even some players where they're committed to colleges and other players who are trying to get one last look before they enter the college level and hope that they can get a scholarship somewhere. So that's at 7 o'clock. Tune in right here with us, and that'll be exciting here at Duckshaw Stadium.
And you can see all of it here on the National Underclassmen live streaming. Gary Griffith along with Ryan Borowski. Ready to start at the 50. The North will have the football first. Now, they've started a couple of quarterbacks as opposed to the South. The South went with just Dimitri Leverett a moment ago on during their 25 plays. I don't know if they can get a shot of number 39 on the South. His name is Nathan, hope I'm pronouncing his right name correctly, Salacia from Richmond Hills High School
looks
in
like
Georgia.
Looks like Troy Polamalu out there.
Well, that's exactly what I was going to say. There seems to be a trend with football players in the last couple of years and letting their hair grow like Troy Polamalu. And that, in fact, is not Troy you're looking at, but the young man I just mentioned, Nathan Salacia from Richmond Hills High School, which is in Georgia. Now, my understanding is, I guess in the NFL, if they grab your hair, that's okay.
Fair game, and actually on an interception I was watching the other day in the NFL, multiple players try to take a defensive back down by his hair. They missed every time, but that is some long hair. He's a junior in high school. That had to be grown since he was in about sixth grade.
All right, here comes the North ready, working from the 50, and the first give is going to be two. That's going to be Khalil Fleming out of Penn High School in Indiana. And in at quarterback, Sebastian Bell. Bell saw some action earlier when they had their set of downs starting at the 10-yard line.
And that time it was Nathan taking him down, like you said, out of Georgia. He blew that play up immediately, rushed off the edge. You could tell he's a football player out there. Doesn't have great height, but he's going to be a great player. He's a junior. He'll be good next year as well.
Alonzo Regna checks in. He's a receiver up at the top side of the field on your screen there, again from the shotgun. The quarterback, Sebastian Bell. Bell has a running back behind him, and he's going to give to that running back, and that's going to be Khalil Fleming once again. Now, the South was showing blitz that time. Earlier on their first set of offensive plays, the South successfully blitzed, and I don't think it was Sebastian Bell whose bell they rung so much as it was Cory Brandon. But apparently the South is not going to be shy, Ryan, about blitzing.
No, it was Elijah Tamarki coming off the edge out of Texas, the outside linebacker. They also sent him along with, obviously, the blitzing defensive end, Salita out of Georgia. But they're going to send the blitz, and it's tough for these O-linemen to communicate. They haven't worked around each other for a long time, so why not send the blitz again? You can't send more than six. That's a rule here in this practice.
From the snap, lateral pass out to the left side going to Liam Haime. Haime, one of the players out of Canada, picks up about 3 yards, pushed out toward midfield. Liam Haime is from Kelvin High School in Canada, not the only Canadian appearing in this practice this afternoon.
Now we have a fourth down situation, fourth and long. And the best part about this practice is there's not a lot of players on each roster, so what they get to do is work on not only their offensive game, but their defensive game as well. Talked about number 57 out there for this North team, how good he is, Nash at linebacker, but hey, now he gets to work on his offensive line skills as well. Come down here to Myrtle Beach all week, and you'll get to work on every single aspect of your game.
Actually, the other Canadian is the man right there, the quarterback, Sebastian Bell, working, taking the snap, dropping back. Looking over on the far sideline, completes a pass once again to Liam Haime. So two pass completions in a row between these two young men from Canada.
And Haime did a great job bringing that one down. There wasn't a lot of mustard on that ball, so he had it hung up there for a while. He got it at his highest point, took a hit from two maroon jerseys, came down, and hey, convert on a first down, or see how they mark that. I believe that was a fourth down. I'm going to say it's fourth down right now, so it'll be fourth and about 5 inches.
North has it at the South 41-yard line. They started this offensive drive at their 50, and there are certain rules that apply to this practice. Each team had so many plays, 25 to be exact, from their 10-yard line and from the 50.
They'll have 25 as well, so now you have the North, and we still have the South to do 50 plays. After this, they'll take it from the 10-yard line going in, work on some red zone offense and defense as well. I believe once we go into the red zone area, each team will have only 15 plays. If we follow the format of last night, that would mean that they would finish off with 10 plays each from the 25-yard line. But that's still about an hour and 20 minutes away, so don't worry.
Well, they're going to walk the ball back to the 50.
Well, what they're going to do is walk it back because I was, like I said, it was fourth down on that completion. They came up a few inches short. That's something you learn. You'll get to the sticks, and actually the receiver had to come back to that so it didn't get intercepted. So it wasn't his fault, but it was a fourth down, and they couldn't convert. So now you bring it back to the 50 like we were talking about with the original rules.
Excuse me just a minute. Give me that hour and a half reference again.
The hour and a half reference? Oh, well, we have plenty of time before we get to where we have to go towards the end, which is the 10-yard line when they do their 10 plays each. So no worries. A lot of football to be played here in this practice.
All right, here comes the North again, reset at their 50. The quarterback remains Sebastian Bell. Blitz shown by the South. Bell recognizes it, tries to make a move on the right side, but gets tripped up, and a nice shoestring tackle by Keith Gordon out of Etowah High School in Georgia.
Keith Gordon comes off the edge, a shoestring tackle, like you said. Quarterback had the right idea in mind. If he made Keith Gordon miss, he would have some running room up ahead, but that's a great tackle, just doing the job. Nothing spectacular, but just getting the guy down and doing what he's asked to do off the edge.
Actually, maybe a loss of a yard on the play. North breaks the huddle. They send a receiver up top. That's Robert Brisbois. And now they're going to put two more receivers over there. Actually, they're going to bring Brisbois from the open side of the field down to the short side of the field. So, again, those three receivers up top and what looks to be like maybe someone's not covered. Now a defender comes in and picks up that man in the slot position. Bell looking downfield, pass in the air, looking for Robert Brisbois, and Brisbois kind of cut to the inside, and the pass went to the outside.
Well, he likes throwing to Brisbois, but number 25, I believe it was for the North team, Fleming, was wide open. He ran about a 7-yard bench route out of the slot position on the top of the screen where they had three wide receivers. There was nobody within 20 yards, and after that play, he saw it go incomplete. He had his hands up to the skies and saying, why not me? I could still be running.
So they'll reset it at the 48-yard line. Remember, they start, they get 25 plays from the 50. And right now it's the North with the football, and then in a moment the South will turn around in this practice, and they'll get their 25 plays. Sebastian Bell's going to back up, work from the shotgun. He's got a running back behind him now. That is Khalil Fleming. Back is Bell, pass in the air, looking for Haime. Pass intercepted. Down at the 38-yard line. Let's see who grabbed that pass.
I believe that was number 44, his second interception of the practice. Caleb Smith, I'm almost positive. He had an interception earlier going the other way, and now he picks one off as well. He's an aggressive cornerback, great at man coverage, and he's great at lurking over the top and making plays as well.
Second interception for Caleb, as Ryan pointed out. And so they back up, put it at the 50, and try again. North breaks the huddle up top once again. Robert Brisbois joining him there. Rhett Adley coming down to the bottom. Liam Haime staying in the backfield. That's going to be Khalil Fleming. The quarterback remains Sebastian Bell. The give is to Green out of the backfield. Straight ahead, back to the line of scrimmage. And he runs into Chevelle Smith.
Couldn't get much off that. Good pressure by the defensive line of this South team. They got great jumps off the edge, came in and shut things down. So, Annette, again, second and 10 now for the North team. And I'm not sure how many plays they have left here at midfield. But, again, after they do this, it'll be turn for the maroon jerseys offensively to come out and have their 25 plays. Maybe about six more plays left for this North team.
Receiver just checked in. That's Justin Breedlove, and Breedlove's going to be his receiver up on the short side of the field, although that's six and one half dozen the other. The ball right in the middle between the hash marks. Blitz shown by the South again. Sebastian Bell's pass in the air, intercepted again by Caleb Smith. And Smith's going to take it all the way back. Caleb Smith with his second interception, Ryan, on this possession.
Second interception on this possession, third one of the game, 6 feet, 180 out of Alabama. Like I said, he's physical, he loves man coverage. Long strides allows him to wreak havoc and multiple pass breakups. How about that for long strides right down the sideline, taking that into the end zone. Again, that's number 44, Caleb Smith, a 2012 NUC All-American Junior Defensive Player of the Year nominee. And several coaches feel that he should have won it. He didn't. They feel that he should have won it. And he's really proven them wrong right now, the people who didn't give him that award, because he's playing his heart out right now.
Don't forget, at 7 o'clock, the seniors will play their game here at Dugshaw Stadium. You can watch that also streaming live here on the National Underclassmen Weekend, I guess is what we should call it. Or they've had
a week.
Oh, yeah, they've had a big week. All right, from the 50 once again, North breaks the huddle. Sebastian Bell, despite having thrown two interceptions in the last minute and a half. But it is a practice, so he'll stay right in there. Wait for the snap. Here it is. Turns, gives to the man out of the backfield who just joined him, and that's Maxwell Sorby.
Sorby took a big hit at the end of the run. This South team looks good so far. Offensively, they look great as well. They just couldn't capitalize and put it in the end zone. But defensively, they look just as good. North has their hands full right now. They're going to need a big play maybe to change this momentum up.
You know, you'd see a lot of these players with the NUC on their helmet. That stands for National Underclassmen. And as we mentioned a moment ago, they've been showcased all week. And this has been a great week for the kids, and this culminates their week of work and invitation to be here in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Right now it's a practice with the juniors. Then at 7 o'clock, the seniors will come out here and play a game.
And they do a good job, NUC. They'll have a combine in this about this time, January, where you'll run your 40-yard dash time, your broad jump, bench press, everything that you'll test at as a football player to show yourself off to scouts. And this is just another addition to that. They've had award dinners all week. The kids have an opportunity to interview in front of the camera, work on some skills that they're going to need when they're around coaches. So awesome, awesome event put on here this week.
Well, speaking of Troy Polamalu, the man we talked about later, his lookalike just came in and smothered the quarterback, Sebastian Bell. That's Nathan Solacia. Very easy to pick up from the stands and on camera with that mane of his hanging out the back of his helmet.
Yeah, that was an unbelievable play, too. He came in and he stuffed it. And like I've said so many times and we talked about yesterday, the lost art in football is tackling. A lot of NFL players will have big hits, but they won't be able to take the person down. That time, Solacia came up, made the hit, and took him down. Great play by the defensive end.
From their own 46-yard line, the North has the football coming down to the bottom side of your screen for the North. It's going to be Justice Breedlove. And in a slot position to his left is another receiver as Sebastian Bell is going to roll that way looking for Breedlove. The pass is intercepted. This time it's Lee Jackson, the third, with the interception. And I believe that's at least the I know that's a third interception. It may be the fourth.
That was the third interception of the drive, fourth of the game. I didn't get a number on who that might have been, number 23.
That's Lee Jackson, a third out of Natchez, Mississippi.
Came up. That's a good interception right there. And you mentioned Breedlove. We had a Breedlove at quarterback yesterday. I'm not sure if there's any relation there. I know we must have had the Washington brothers. Both had the same helmet on, one being a freshman, one being a sophomore.
But well, Sebastian Bell, sorry, has thrown three interceptions since they started at the 50. But earlier in the game, I'm not sure if it was Bell or one of the other quarterbacks, Corey Brandon, who threw an interception. So I've got him down for four.
That might have been the quarterback. And again, that was the first sequence of plays in this practice, the 25. And they are still on their first 25 here at the 50-yard line.
North ready once again, coming out to take the snap again is the quarterback Sebastian Bell, despite having thrown three interceptions. But that's part of the process here in this practice. Just take your lumps, keep on working. Running back behind Sebastian Bell. Bell back in the pocket, looking way downfield, has an open receiver, but the pass almost intercepted again by Caleb Smith. The intended receiver, Robert Brisbois, was open down the sideline, but the pass curved back into the middle of the field.
Yeah, Brisbois was wide open down the center of the sideline. If he could put a little bit more on that would have been a touchdown for the North, and they could have really used that because they're struggling right now. That almost was the third interception, I believe, for number 44 on the South's roster. We've seen him a few times. Caleb Smith, just an athlete out there playing center field for the South team.
So no gain on the play for the North. They have it at their 50-yard line. And after they complete their plays, the South will get their set of downs from the 50. Gary Griffith here with Ryan Borowski in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, where the sun is still making quite an appearance. I think the sun shines, 300 days out of the year, something like that, in Myrtle Beach.
Is that what they say?
I think I'm close.
Well, the sun is out today, and more importantly, the wind has stopped. The wind was crazy yesterday, blowing left to right on this field, but it really slowed down last night and into today.
Bell back in the pocket, rolling to his right. He's just going to throw it away, looking over on the side. And looked like for a minute he may have had an open receiver, Kelvin Brown, but Brown was already out of bounds, so Bell just threw it out of bounds, and I believe that's going to do it for the North on their 50.
Chevelle Smith was tracking him down. He wanted that sack bad, but like you said, Bell threw it away. Smith still took him down to the ground and was pounding the ground. He wanted that sack, work on his numbers here in this scrimmage. Chevelle Smith out of Alabama, Russell County.
All right, now it's the South and Dimitri Leverett. Leverett handled all the quarterbacking duties earlier for the South.
Well, yeah, Leverett's out there right now, and he had a good first drive. He moved the ball just a bit down the field, and just an interception to end it on their 25th play. But I'd like to see the South finish things off. They're good offensively and also defensively as well.
You know, I don't know if the camera can pan, I believe, one of the players on the North, but one young man had a helmet on that looked like looked just like a University of Kentucky helmet. Just caught my eye, that's all.
Yeah,
see who that is.
There's a few helmets out there that kind of replicate college teams, and one with a Kansas State type logo, and you see the dark helmets, the white helmets, some of the gunmetal helmets, the dull black that we've seen from Oregon a few years, and then the one out there that's identical to a Florida State helmet. Actually, someone on the South roster had it as well, 46. I think that was Smith who just made the sack. He's sitting on the bench right now, but he has a helmet identical to the Florida State Seminoles. So it's interesting to look at some of these helmets and see where these players are from and what their high schools have for mascots.
Jonte Gadsden in motion from right to left. They give, however, to Jarrett Mitchell. Mitchell out of Kubasai High School out there in California. Didn't even make it back to the line of scrimmage. Taken down there, and the tackle made by Mark Nicholas. Nicholas out of McKinley Tech in Washington, D.C. Now, the quarterback here for the South is Dimitri Leverett from Florida. And we noticed on the first offensive set of downs for the South that Everett certainly has, we're not quite sure how accurate or arm, but we think it's pretty accurate. But he certainly can throw the ball the distance.
Take a look at number 42 in the backfield. You just said it, Jarrett Mitchell. He's a running back, 4.4 speed. He played his entire life of football in Japan for the Kubaski Dragons.
Quarterback keeper is going to be Dimitri Leverett. He takes it inside North Territory down to the North 40. Now, what you just mentioned about the young man from Kubasai, probably is how it's pronounced, high school, I'm going to guess that his dad's probably in the military, perhaps, over there in Japan, stationed over there, not sure.
And another player actually relevant to football that grew up in Japan as well, Robert Griffin III, spent much of his younger days in Japan.
At the North 42-yard line, the South will send Gadsden in motion. Leverett, long count, kind of a high snap, wants to pass. Everybody's covered, so he drops back. Looks back to his right, trying to go back underneath to Gadsden.
That's incomplete. That's a tough pass to make. He's throwing off his back foot, but hey, the best part about it is he had the whereabouts to get out of the pocket. Don't take the sack. Now you have a fourth and short instead of what could have been a third and long if he took a sack. So good play right there by the young quarterback.
Actually, he was looking for Markell Jones. Jones out of Montebello High School in Colorado. Jones stays in. He'll be a wide receiver at the top of your screen. Coming down to the bottom is Theo Mordecai. Mordecai had a 35-yard pass, hit him right in the hands earlier. I mean, it couldn't have been a better place, but he dropped the ball. Leverett receiving some last-minute instructions. He'll work up under center for the first time. Blitz is shown by the North. They realize that Leverett working under center. Quarterback keeper to the right, maybe a yard, maybe two. Not quite sure what that was about unless it was by design.
He got it on the second effort. It was the first time he made an attempt to go forward. They actually stuffed him, but a good job staying consistent with it, moving those legs, keeping them moving. And there it is, a first down. Quarterback sneaks aren't necessarily an athletic play. Tom Brady's actually one of the better quarterbacks in the NFL to ever run quarterback sneaks. It's just where you find the hole. And that time, he didn't go straight up towards the blitz. He went around towards the right and found just enough room to get the first down.
They moved the chains across the way. Of course, the chains took a direct hit earlier, and one of those set of chains is, I guess, being held together with some duct tape over there. Whoever's holding those chains, they're following the play. They won't be in the direct line of the next play. Here's a bad snap way over Leverett's head. He kicks it all the way back, recovers, throws upfield, and it's intercepted by the North And it looks like that's going to be the Norse Tanner Hughes who made the interception. He brings it back.
Tanner Hughes, that's an unbelievable interception. That ball was rocketed by Leverett just trying to throw it away. Hughes looks up and he sees the ball coming firing right at him. Great hands for him right there, number 45. You see him on the screen and he takes it into the other direction. Really one of the better plays we've seen by this North squad all afternoon.
Well, part of this practice is just that, to practice. Now that particular play, Leverett had the ball sailed way over his head. He had to chase it back. And he perhaps would have served his team better by just throwing it out of bounds, but instead he tried to make a play, rushed it, and he was intercepted.
Well, and then in a game situation, most likely you'll see Leverett just hop on that ball and fall on it and then take the bullet and keep going. But that time, and it's in a practice, you want to pick it up. You want to try to make a play because you know even if you throw that interception, hey, look, I'm going to be right back out here again for the next play. Yeah, it's a lot of concentration. Good job by number 10. We saw them early on in warm-ups down there on the field. They've been working together a lot between him and also Gadsden. That's a good deep ball right there by Leverett, the quarterback for this South team. And like you said, good catch, good concentration. Now they're in business to maybe get this across the finish line.
So the South down at the North 13-yard line. New running back in the backfield. That's Gannon Hinkst. And Hinkst will take the handoff. Maybe got back to the line of scrimmage. Hinkst maybe a yard, but not much more. Quentin Hall finished him off.
Hinkst tried to cut that back. He had some room on the cutback. There wasn't a lot of blockers out in front. Not a bad decision by him. Not a loss of yards. Second and 10 right now.
South operating way down in North territory at the North 13-yard line. On the strength of that pass completion a moment ago from Dimitri Leverett way downfield to Jonte Gadsden. And Gadsden's a receiver way up top. In fact, three receivers up top, one to the short side. That's Mordecai. High snap, give to Hinkst. Hinkst trying to go around the right side. Loses the football. It's on the ground. And I believe the North is going to indicate they've recovered.
Another turnover for this South team. And, yes, it's not a game. It's just a practice. But you still want to be able to put it into the end zone. I believe they should retreat this all the way back to the 50-yard line right now if that's a fumble and a change of possession. So we'll be back to the 50. And the South really can't punch it in. We've seen some interceptions defensively. The North defense is stepping up right now with an interception and now a forced fumble.
Well, here's something you don't see every day. Looks like I'm assuming that's one of the coaches down on the field. I see he's on the phone. Now, you're certainly not going to see that during a real game.
Well, he has the Belichick hoodie on, though. He looks like Bill Belichick from up here.
What about if it was Bill Belichick?
So they'll be back at the 50-yard line now. And, again, it's first down. They have 25 plays. So would you say they ran half their plays?
Oh, yeah. Back at the 50, here comes the South again. Leverett remains a quarterback. Three receivers down low, one up top. Quick screen pass out to Mordecai at the 49, 45, 40, 35 down to the 34-yard line. First pass reception to Theo Mordecai. Mordecai out of Friendship Collegiate High School in Maryland. Although earlier in the game, we noted that Mordecai had a long pass of about 35 yards. Hit him right in the hands. He just didn't make the catch. We have a player down on the North, and let's see if we can get a read on that. I believe that's Raine Grant.
Yeah, he went down, and Mordecai, a receiver for the South team, a big body out there. You mentioned the drop pass, but he's a big kid. He's going to be great in his high school career, and like you said, we do have a player down for this North team, so they have a great training staff here to take a look at him and make sure that he's okay. Again, the NUC practice here between the juniors.
Player down on the field, there's shot a minute ago of Chris Redmond. Big smile on his face. Redmond out of Ridgeview, South Carolina. He seemed to be enjoying the afternoon.
And he's been playing great. He's a defensive tackle. He could be a great run stopper, but at the same time, you've seen him drop him back in coverage. When you have a big guy like that with that athletic ability, why not use him in different ways? And now we'll see the North player get up to his feet right now.
All right, Raine Grant makes his way up to his feet. Think he's going to be all right. He's going to walk over to his sideline. He plays for the North. This is a practice here. And these are the juniors here in this national underclassmen practice. And then the seniors will play at 7 o'clock. You can watch that also on the national underclassmen live streaming video, live from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina.
That's going to be a good one.
South breaks the huddle. They have it at the North 34-yard line. And Gadsden's a quarterback. He's going to turn, throw it over to Leverett. Leverett's going to look into the end zone for a Mordecai touchdown. No, he dropped the ball. Theo Mordecai, second time today, Ryan. He's had it in his hand.
Oh, Mordecai had that right in the breadbasket, and all the fans have their hands on their head. That was, I saw them run that play in warm-ups. I wasn't sure when they were going to throw it into the mix. Ran it, executed it perfectly. Oh, and Mordecai dropped it. It looked like it was even in his hands for a second or so before it came down to the ground. Ooh.
Well, the minute I saw Jonte Gadsden line up as a quarterback, I thought something was up, and something was. He turned and threw a lateral pass over to the quarterback, Dimitri Leverett. Leverett looking into the end zone for Theo Mordecai, and Mordecai was open. Mordecai stays in the game, one of the wide receivers. Leverett back in at quarterback. Elijah Tamarki in the backfield. Check that. That's going to be Joel Evans to give us to Evans. Off right tackle down to close to the 31-yard line. He's ganged up on there, finishing him off, Tyree Tomlinson.
The most disappointing part about that last play is when you run trick plays, you know they're not going to work often. You use them once, and then that's probably it for the entire game. So you have your one shot at that play. And if they executed that, that would have been perfect. You know, the coaching staff and all the players would have loved that. I would be shocked to see if they try to do that again now that the defense is already
up top. Tyler, Tyler Bedlinger, Jonte Gadsden, Theo Mordecai down, split wide on the bottom, and somebody jumps off defensively for the North. And they are calling the penalties in this practice.
So they will push him back, a false start penalty. So it goes from about 3rd and 9 to now about a 3rd and 14 for the South team.
Now after this completion of offensive plays from the 50, refreshes again on, they'll start at the 10.
Well, now they will go to the 10-yard line after this, and they'll run 15 plays each. What we did last night for the freshman and sophomore practice is after they ran from the 50-yard line, they went to the 10-yard line, ran 15 plays each, and then they finished from the 25-yard line and ran 10 plays each and called it. So that's what they did last night. I'm not positive if we're going to stick to that same exact format, but so far we are. Probably about 6 or 7 plays left for this South team.
At the 34-yard line of the North, Leverett looking down in the end zone for Mordecai. This time Mordecai hangs on. Did he get inside the pylon? The ball popped out. He hung on to it. And so Mordecai, Theo Mordecai, who had dropped one a couple of plays ago, this time Ryan, he hangs on.
And Mordecai is a big receiver. Tell you what, he had a few drops today, but you could tell he's just a great athlete out there. No matter what, the hands will get better as he goes. He's going to be an awesome player. He's from Maryland, a lot of talent up there in that area, and he's a great receiver. That's a good catch down there. Thought well, they stepped out of bounds, but they didn't call it.
Sorry, Ryan. They should utilize Mordecai's height. He's going to go about 6'2 or 3. And if you get him isolated on a shorter cornerback or safety, you can utilize his height. And that's exactly what the South did a minute ago. The South will keep the football back at the 50. Leverett still the quarterback. In fact, I'm going to assume, Ryan, he's going to be the only quarterback. Another bad snap, going back, Hinkst picks it up, in trouble, back at the 35 to the 36, swarmed and taken down. Ishmael McNeil finishes him off.
And you could tell that number 81 out there for the South, he just looks like he plays the part. Mordecai looks the part, plays the part, almost looks like an Andre Johnson or even a Dez Bryant out there. He has the visor going as well. Talented receiver, and I think that might be their 50th play. With Leverett's helmet off, we'll see what they say. Or their 25th, excuse me.
Right now the ball is at the South 37-yard line. And the South's going to break the huddle off the right hash mark. Theo Mordecai in a one-on-one coverage against Rhett Adley. Let's see if they try to manipulate this. Rolling to his left is Leverett. Wants to pass. Looking downfield. Fires. Completes a pass to Mordecai. Inside North territory, Mordecai did a great job coming back to that ball.
That's what I talked about earlier. It's called scramble rules. If you're going deep, which Mordecai was doing, he came back, settled down, found a little bit of room towards the sideline. That was an absolute bullet right there by Leverett. That's the best throw we've seen him make all day.
All right, the South has it at the North 45-yard line, just inside the left hash mark. Now a lone receiver up at the top. It's Markill Jones. One running back in the backfield, Joel Evans, along with the quarterback, Leverett. Leverett takes a good snap, rolling to his right, plenty of time, fires upfield, completes the pass to Markill Jones, a man who had gotten in that one-on-one coverage all the way down to the 25-yard line of the North.
And now you see the South moving the ball, but I think that'll be their 25th play. Unfortunate, they did get a touchdown on that sequence of plays, though, so now you'll see the North come back out.
And it seems to me, I'll get your comments on this, that the quarterback, Dimitri Leverett, for the South, the longer the game progresses, the more accurate he's becoming.
Yeah, he's starting to really settle in his role as that offensive player in the quarterback position for this South team. You see him heading to the sidelines right now, but his deep ball looks great, and his underneath throw, the last one, Mordecai, was the best throw we've seen him make all day. He's a talented player out there, again, from Florida, wearing the Florida Gator colors as well. And it looks like they sent him from the 15-yard line. I was incorrect. I said from the 10-yard line, but they'll work on the red zone offense from the 15.
Again, no true quarterback in the backfield, Khalil Fleming. And also with Fleming, that is Maxwell Sorby. So they have two running backs. The snap to Fleming, wants to pass, looks in the end zone, pass deflected, almost intercepted by the South. Now, again, Khalil Fleming is listed as a running back, but for all we know, he may have seen a little action as quarterback.
Number 41 for this South team out there, Markell King. Take a look at his helmet out there, almost identical to the Jacksonville Jaguars, as I almost take a wipe up here in the booth. I'm all right, though.
Well, the North has it first, trying to get in the end zone. They break the huddle. They've got three receivers down at the bottom of the screen, one up top, and Khalil Fleming remains in the backfield along with Maxwell Sorby. Fleming with a long count, takes a snap, keeps it himself, straight up the middle, still on his feet, now knocked back, no gain on the play whatsoever. And they get 15 offensive plays, remember, from the 15, and the North, that is, and then when they are through, the South will have their shot.
Here we go, they'll have, looks like the dial marker says first down over there.
I see the chain crew. They've just said forget it. They've laid their chains down.
Well,
why not?
And when they're from the 10-yard line.
Exactly.
Not necessary to have the chain crew out there. And after the beating they took earlier and the bent chain, maybe give it a rest. Don't forget those chains have to last throughout the game tonight as well.
All right, here comes the North at the South. Well, they've got it at about the 10-yard line, maybe at the 9. Fleming remaining as the quarterback, and he's going to give to the man behind him, Maxwell Sorby. Sorby cuts in the middle of the field, gets down to the 3, and a flag on the play.
Yeah, late flag came in. I'll be interested to see what they say. And it will be holding, and they'll bring that play back. That was probably the best play so far by this North team, and goes down to the 2-yard line and gets called back for holding.
So they will bring this back. Now, earlier on the other offensive possessions, the North was using primarily Sebastian Bell as their quarterback, but no Sebastian Bell to be seen. They're going with Khalil Fleming. Fleming out of Penn High School in Indiana.
A lot of Midwest players playing in these games as well. We saw a few yesterday, some more here today. Just going down the list, you have California, Texas, North Carolina, Georgia, Virginia, Alabama, Kentucky, Maryland, Tennessee, Oklahoma. There's kids from everywhere, and it's awesome not only to bring them together, play some football, but it's nice to meet people outside of your state, outside of your comfort zone. They can all go back and tell their other high school teammates that they met a kid from Texas, played with a kid from Texas, and all of those great things.
Well, now it's Maxwell. Sorby, the up man in the backfield, he'll take the direct snap, drops the ball, in trouble, backs up, almost takes out the coaching squad on the field.
Chevelle Smith got in a hurry. I'm not sure how fast his 40-yard dash time is. He's a defensive lineman. He came in there so fast. By the time that ball was picked up, he dropped the quarterback right down to the ground. That's the second good play we've seen by him this evening. He's a great player for that South team's defensive line.
Well, that is one hazard. If you let the coaching staff come out on the field, then they have to win in Rome, as they say. And a couple of those coaches almost got wiped out. So we've lost a chain earlier. The chain markers, one of those took a direct hit. Now the coaches are going to get in on the action.
But in a practice situation like this, benefits the players to have the coach right there. And now look who we have at quarterback for the North team.
Well, we earlier heard there may be some trading going on. So
in-practice trading, I guess.
In practice, Dimitri Leverett,
no trade deadline.
The quarterback for the South, is going to quarterback for the North. Somebody's got to do it. He takes a snap. He's going to keep him himself. He gets swamped under. He was looking for help out of the backfield from Khalil Fleming.
Well, what do you do now if you're Leverett? You're cheering on your team defensively the whole entire practice, and now you get sacked and everybody's pounding their chests on your team. I don't know. You might be better off staying with the North after that celebration after they took him down.
Well, Leverett comes in, helps out the North, and then his own teammates come in there and swamp him over. And I believe that's it for the offensive drives for the North. And now it looks like it'll be the South turn. If you're Leverett, I'm sure not a moment too soon.
Now they'll have their share of plays from the, I believe they put it at the 15-yard line. And I think they have 15 plays.
Well, quarterback Dimitri Leverett, very nice of him to come in and run that play for the North, but he got swamped. I'm not so sure. He's not a little groggy.
Well, and I'm not sure the North's quarterback, number 7, I haven't seen him. He might be hurt.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering. Well, I see Sebastian Bell across the way.
Sebastian Bell was the quarterback for the entire game, and he might be getting tended to on the sidelines. He went down hard on one of the last plays he ran, so that's probably why now they're improvising at the quarterback position with running backs, and they put Leverett there in their last possession.
Well, now the South gets their crack from the 10-yard line. Leverett will remain the quarterback. He has Theo Mordecai up top on a one-on-one coverage. He connected with Mordecai earlier for a touchdown. And before Leverett can get the play away, they stop. And I'm assuming there's a timeout on the field.
Yeah, they'll repeat the first down. They'll push him back 5 yards. That was a false start penalty, but it kind of looked like it could have went both ways from here. The defensive line jumped as well.
Three receivers to the bottom of your screen. Mordecai up top, high snap. Leverett grabs the ball. He's going to be swamped under before he can react. Coming in is Ishmael McNeil all over Leverett.
And we've called his name a few times, McNeil, out of Texas. He's been having a pretty good game here so far for this North, pretty good practice he's putting together for this North team.
So that backs the South up to their 22-yard line. And they bring in Lee Jackson, the third, and for the first time today, Jackson will be a wide receiver. And Mordecai, for the moment, out of the ball game, looking in the end zone. Leverett's pass in the air, complete to an open Jonte Gadsden. Second pass completion between Leverett and Gadsden tonight.
They had a big one down on the other end of the field. This time it's Gadsden. Leverett has a great arm, and like you said it perfectly. As the game goes on, he's getting better and better. The accuracy, the strength in his arm on a deep ball. And Gadsden, second time he came down out of Colorado, second time he came down with a great catch here this afternoon.
Well, they get X amount of plays, 15 from the 10-yard line, so that only took about three plays. So the South gets to exercise 10 or 12 more plays, and their only quarterback throughout the contest has been the young man Dimitri Leverett out of Bartow High School in Florida. In fact, he's done a heck of a job. He even ran one play for the North.
Yeah, he's been doing it for the North and for the South, the one play for the North, but he can do it with his legs. That's no secret. And he's also doing it with his arm as well. We talked about it earlier. 6 feet, 185 pounds. He's a quarterback, but he's also an athlete. That's somebody that can play a different position in college. If there's some coaches going after him that want him to play the receiver position, he can do that. But I'm sure as many quarterbacks are, they want to stay at that quarterback position. They're comfortable there. And I'm not so sure he can do that. I think he'll be perfect at that quarterback position. No need to change him the way he's playing this afternoon. And I hope the college coaches see this highlight tape.
Well, as the game progresses, everything's getting friendlier and friendlier. The entire South team is out on the field. They're not all directly involved in this competition. This is starting to look like in your backyard when you call everybody in and say, who wants to play? Now Leverett's going to work under center for only the second time in this practice. Double tight end formation. And the give is going to be to Cannon Inkst. And he gets stood up at the line of scrimmage. So they've got about 10 more plays to run here from the 10-yard line, and now one of the coaches congratulating Leverett about something. Well, this is, as I said, getting to be rather friendly. You've got coaches intermingling with all the players.
And now they're, like you were saying, now they're going to have the coaches out there, and that's good, though. They can work on everything that they're trying to work on, and like you mentioned, double tight end formation. We haven't seen that a lot. It's nice to see them get out of the spread formation, power down, get into some real, real football right here.
An old wishbone formation in the backfield now for the South. No receivers anywhere. Here's the give to Inkst. Inkst. Nope. A quarterback keeper by Leverett around the left side. He'll take it into the end zone. I'm glad I'm not working the camera. He fooled me. So Leverett beginning to take control single-handedly in this ball game for the South.
I'll tell you right now, Leverett looks like a boy or a man amongst boys out there. He's looking unbelievable for this quarterback position on the South team. He can do it with his legs and also with his arm that we've seen. Really, really great job. He can keep this highlight tape for future coaches.
Well, the excess players who were on the field a moment ago for the South, they have decided to go on over to the sideline. The South still has the ball at the 10-yard line. They set it up again. Again, wishbone running formation. And the give is going to be to Joel Evans. Evans out of Riverside Durham High School picks up 1 yard, makes it down to the 9. And they should be about to expire their number of plays, don't you think?
I think you might be a little ahead of the game because that touchdown pass that they threw was on their second or third play, and I think you counted that as maybe their fifth or sixth. So don't worry, plenty of plays to go here. I would estimate about six more is what I would say.
Well, this is obviously by design as this practice has been as they are now working on what looks like the old wishbone formation. And the give is this time going to go to Jarrett Mitchell, the young man out of Kubasai High School.
And you'll see Caleb Smith putting his hands up. He wanted that touchdown call right there. Good lead blocking by number 44 in the maroon jersey out there. They're down to the inch yard line. I'd like to see them power this in with a running back. That's a beautiful camera shot right there. You see where that ball lies right in front of the goal line, and you see the defensive coach coaching up the defensive tackles right now on what to do. Probably going to tell them to just dive at the feet of the old lineman and have the linebackers come in over the top. We'll get a pretty good close-up view here, though.
South has it. South has it from the one-foot line. Everybody's stacked up the line of scrimmage, and they give it to Chris Redmond. And he's in. Redmond had lined up in the backfield.
I'll tell you what, 345 pounds. I don't see a lot of people pushing him back right there as you see him at the fullback position just bowled his way in. Hey, he's big, but he's got some wheels underneath him. They dropped him back in coverage, and now they have him playing some running back position. Big number 53 out there from South Carolina.
Chris Redmond is listed as a defensive tackle, but they had him in the backfield like years ago. The Bears used to extend
the
refrigerator, Perry. course, who was from South Carolina and played at Clemson. Ball resting still at the 10-yard line because they run a set of 15 plays from the 10-yard line. Receivers everywhere. One running back, that's Jarrett Mitchell, to the right of the quarterback. Leverett, three-step drop. Everybody's covered. He's got room on the left side. He's going to angle for the pylon. Puts his right shoulder down. Did he get in? He did.
He did. And look at how fast Leverett is right there. Gets around the edge, sneaks into the pylon. Leverett's, I think everybody's seen what they need to see out of Leverett today. This kid could ball. He could do it through the air. He could do it on the ground. And he could lead his players out onto the field. Great play right there by the guy wearing the Florida Gator color Under Armour.
And Leverett making some wise decisions, which is part of this practice, not just the numbers, but you want to see good decisions from quarterbacks. And that time everybody was covered, and Leverett chose to try to angle toward that pylon. Knew he had open field and made it. Not sure if this is going to be it or not.
No, it looks like they're going to move back to the 25-yard line, and if they stick to the script of last night, both teams will have 10 plays. My only concern is that the North doesn't have a quarterback right now, so if they're going to keep putting running backs at that position, we'll see. Unless one of the other players was listed as a slash. I know their Bell, the starting quarterback is out of the game.
Well, the North will have it at the 25-yard line without a true quarterback. What they're going to do is put Khalil Fleming in the backfield. Now, Dimitri Leverett, the quarterback for the South, pretty much had volunteered to play for the North, but I guess they're going to let Fleming run the offense. He takes a snap. He'll keep it himself. Down to the 21, tackle there, and they'll try it again.
Well, and the good part about getting a practice together like this is you have parents coming from all over, flying in from all different parts of the country. You know that you're going to have guaranteed set number of plays. We estimated about a little bit under 200 plays as these two teams continue to go at it. So it's good for the parents to see their kids out here, because if you're playing in a regular game situation, you don't know how much time of possession your kid will have on the field, how much time they'll spend on the sideline, because that's just like a regular football game. This, you have guaranteed number of plays, and like I said, from the 25-yard line, they should have 10 plays each right now.
Well, again, Fleming will stay in at quarterback. The North quarterback, Sebastian Bell, is over on the sideline, but he's not in the ball game. Man in motion, left to right, and the give is going to be to that young man. That is Rhett Adley. Adley's going to get back to the line of scrimmage, and they'll try it again at about the 25-yard line.
And good speed right there by Adley coming across the edge. He just didn't have a lot of blockers out in front of him. But he took that ball in a hurry and got there in a hurry as well. Good speed for Rhett Adley out of Massachusetts.
Now, how many plays from the 25?
Believe there will be 10 unless they stick to a different script.
Certainly some terminology you don't usually associate with a football game is script. A literal script is what I mean. The football at the 23-yard line, and the North will slowly come out of their huddle and keep in the backfield. Once again, Khalil Fleming, he's going to operate as the quarterback. He'll take the direct snap. No protection in the backfield to help him. Adley in motion, but a quarterback keeper by Fleming inside the 20 down to the 17-yard line.
That's the best play we've seen him have so far on this end of the field. Good run, got about 7 yards off the carry. Also wanted to mention, it looks like we have some more fans filing in for our senior game here, which will happen in about an hour and 20 minutes. Well, about an hour and a half from now, we'll have the senior game right here. Stay tuned, and that should be a good one.
Tell you what, Fleming's getting all the reps he needs, and he's having a good weekend for himself.
at the end of the day, you just want to get as many reps as possible to be as good as you can be and get as better as you or as better as you can be. And Fleming's getting a lot of reps now at the quarterback position, not only as he was taken earlier at the running back position.
North breaks the huddle. They do have receivers left and right, but Fleming has not attempted a pass just yet. Now they're going to back up to the 25 again. And so right in the middle of the field, the North ready from the 25-yard line. South has about three safeties 25 yards off the line, so they're expecting perhaps sooner or later for Fleming to attempt a pass. Here's the snap to Khalil Fleming. Adley again in motion, and again a keeper by Khalil Fleming. He's got room up the middle, gets past the defender, angling in, makes it to the end zone. Khalil Fleming on a 25-yard run.
And it was a great run by Fleming. Came in, took a few hits, knocked himself into the end zone. And that's great vision right there as a running back, even though he was from the quarterback position. That's vision. You look to the left, you look to the right, you see where the cutback lane is. He found the cutback lane. He found his way into the end zone. And finally, some life for the North, even though half their team's still hanging out on the bench over there. Really a big play for them. We have the seniors rolling in as well.
25-yard run by Khalil Fleming. Touchdown run for the North. They break the huddle again. Down below us, we see the seniors beginning to, the senior players, that is, filing in. They'll get dressed, and then they'll be up at 7 o'clock. Right now, it's this practice for the juniors here in this national underclassmen practice at Dugshaw Stadium. Again, from the 25-yard line, Khalil Fleming is going to keep it himself. Again, up the middle, stood up at the 21-yard line, driven back. Momentum will place the ball at the 20.
And I would have to say they're nearing their 10 plays if that's what they're going to run. And again, 7 o'clock start, so about an hour and a half for these seniors to get ready. And not only will it be more difficult for, for us it'll be more difficult, as you see. Up until this point, we've had about 30 men rosters, and I think we've just witnessed about 70 guys walk right across our front of us. So we'll have a lot of names to look at for that game, but that should be exciting. And again, 10 plays from the 25 for each team. I bet you the North is probably about on their seventh play right now.
Receivers left and right, although Khalil Fleming has not attempted a pass. He's in the backfield. Again, Sebastian Bell, the quarterback, has not made a reappearance. Here's a handoff to Adley. Rhett Adley. Adley gets absolutely nowhere. Well, he's been going in motion for the last four or five plays. Sooner or later, he had to touch the ball.
Yeah, and Keith Gordon took him down, a linebacker out of Georgia. He had a good play early on, and then he just capitalizes on that opportunity, rushing off the outside and taking him down for about a 7-yard loss. So good tackle for loss right there by Gordon, the linebacker for the South.
Well, evening is descending on Dugshaw Stadium. We're literally about 2.5 blocks off the Atlantic Ocean. Here at Dugshaw Stadium, which is the home field for the Myrtle Beach High School Seahawks, they had a great year this year. Back at the 31-yard line, a blitz is shown by the South. Adley now is going to be the quarterback. He takes it, rolling to his left, wants to pass, has a receiver down in the end zone, but the ball is intercepted at the goal line by the South. Bringing it out for the South, that's going to be Markel King. South has intercepted the North about five times to my count.
And there's a few things I wanted to note on that play. Rhett Adley, the quarterback on that play. Let me see what he's listed at right here. Listed as a wide receiver. That throw was a great throw for a wide receiver. Yes, it was an interception, but he got it down the field. He created some space. Second thing I wanted to note is his effort. Came back and tackled the guy who intercepted it, ran from the 10-yard line all the way across the field. Can't coach that. That's just great effort right there by Adley to tackle the defensive back.
South leaning for the North to break the huddle. The ball resting back at the 25-yard line.
Right now this one started at 4 o'clock, so creeping on that 6 o'clock mark, and just about a half hour from now, and the North has their final opportunity at offense. Again, the North lost their quarterback, Bell, who's on the bench right now. He started at number 7 out there. He went down with an injury, so now they're just improvising out there and doing a pretty decent job at it.
North taking their time, breaking the huddle. Here they come. Ball back at the 25-yard line. Receivers up top for the North. One of those, Robert Brisbois, down to the bottom side. One of those receivers is Nabiel Hussain, and also in the slot, that's Adley, the quarterback, Khalil Fleming. Fleming working in the shotgun. A blitz is shown by the South. A handoff is going to be mishandled in the backfield. Fleming was trying to find Maxwell Sorby. Sorby was coming in motion from left to right. And I believe the North truly was knocked out of sync because of that blitz shown by the South.
Yeah, good blitz right there by the South. And the North really are just kind of lost right now without the quarterback. They're doing everything they can, and they've actually scored a TD on this sequence of plays. But just tough out there when you don't have a quarterback, when you don't have your set offense that you worked on all week long to be able to input that offense. So now you're kind of going around with different players and asking them to do different things that they haven't necessarily been prepared to do. And here's the last 10 plays now for the South.
So they switch sides. The South will have their 10 plays from the 25-yard line. And then that should wrap up the practice. Leverett's going to work as a wide receiver.
Here we go. Now we'll get to see. I talked about he's a quarterback, but he could also be a wide receiver. He's an athlete. They're probably going to run this play, but I would like to see them throw it to him, see if he can go up and make a catch. Here they go. It's the same play as before.
And they do throw it to Leverett. They call the play dead before he can release. Jonte Gadsden is the quarterback now for the South.
Well, that was the same play they ran before when they dropped the ball into the end zone. They had him again open on the backside of the formation, number 81, who we saw earlier, Mordecai. But that time it was just Leverett going down, and he took a knee before he can get up and throw it.
And again, the snap to Gadsden, passes to Leverett. Leverett wants to look into the end zone. Cox's arm has his arm deflected. His arm was moving forward. So it's pretty obvious now the South practicing this play where Jonte Gadsden is the quarterback, takes a snap, takes one step back, throws a lateral pass to Dimitri Leverett, and then Leverett looks for a receiver in the end zone.
Well, that time the outside linebacker wasn't fooled at all. He came in and blitzes. We see Ken running across the field showing off his speed. But we saw the outside linebacker came in, blitzed on that, and he wasn't letting Leverett get that ball off at all, and he couldn't. He got in there quick, and Leverett had a tough time. But like you said, fortunately enough, his arm was going forward, so it was an incomplete pass.
All right, here comes the South. Let's see what Leverett is going to do. He will now come back in and work as a quarterback, and then Jonte Gadsden is going to be a wide receiver. And in the backfield for the South is Joel Evans. Snap to Leverett, plenty of time. Screen pass over on the left side, overshoots his man, looking there for Evans, and a flag on the play.
Holding on the South, and the best part about that play was Leverett. He went through every single one of his progressions, scanned across the field right to left, went off to the screen pass. Although he did overthrow him on the scat route, he had the right idea in mind, but again, it was a holding call anyways on the South, so it wouldn't have mattered even if they completed that. And that was their third play of this sequence.
So to our accounting, there are 10, seven plays remaining in the practice.
That's what I would say.
And then we'll wrap it up right away for a while. I'll be back at 7 o'clock with the senior game. And that will be a game at 7 o'clock here on the National Underclassmen video that you're watching. Well, they back up to the 40-yard line. Dimitri Leverett will stand at the 45. He'll keep Evans in the backfield with him. In motion left to right is Jonte Gadsden, three-step drop.
Just overthrew him. Was that? I'm not sure. I didn't get a number on that, but that was another great deep ball. That's on a third and long, and now it's fourth and long. I'd like to see them take that shot. But once again, Leverett is a great ball player out there, and he actually had the receiver overthrew him probably about 6 inches.
Dimitri Leverett just put the ball in the air 55-plus yards. He was at the 45 when he threw that pass. So six more plays here in this practice. The ball resting at the 39-yard line of the North. The South has the ball.
They might be drawing up a trick play right here on fourth and forever. What is it, fourth and 15, fourth and 25 about for these South players out there. So they might be drawing up something tricky in the huddle. That was a long huddle for this South team.
Well, Theo Mordecai back in the ball game for the Southies in a one-on-one coverage up top. Leverett rolling to his right, under pressure, looking for a receiver, and finds an open man. 20 yards upfield, that's Markel Jones. Now, Theo Mordecai is working on a one-on-one coverage up at the top of your screen, working there against Justice Breedlove.
Now, this should retreat him back to the 25-yard line, if I'm not mistaken, if that was fourth down. And now the official will pick the ball up, and he should bring him right back to the 25. Maybe I should be out there officiating. Yep, and there it is.
So they walk down to the 25-yard line. They should have five more plays. Right now the South in possession of the football, and some of the senior players beginning to make their way out onto the field. We'll watch them at 7 o'clock in a game here at Dugshaw Stadium. North versus South. A lot of players will be involved in that ball game. All right, here come the juniors at the 25-yard line. The South with the football. One running back, Jarrett Mitchell, in the backfield along with the quarterback, Dimitri Leverett. Leverett, three-step drop, pass over on the left side, in and out of the hands of his intended receiver. And he had a wide-open Lee Jackson, the third, over there.
Leverett threw that off the back of his foot, and he's still got enough arm strength on that. That speaks to his arm strength out there at the quarterback position.
And they'll try it again from the 25-yard line. Now, I don't know if we're going to know how to react in the senior game when they actually move more than, you know, set downs.
We'll have to adjust after going back-to-back practices. Broadcasting practices isn't something that I've done before, but, hey, now we got the game coming up, so it should be exciting.
Blitz shown by the North, and we do have offsides on the North, so believe it or not, with only a couple plays remaining, they're going to call it tight to the very end. And whether or not they're going to walk this off, they will, so the South will have it at the 20. Throughout the game, the only quarterback the South has used has been Dimitri Leverett. He takes a snap, looking to his left, everybody covered, rolls to his right, fires into the end zone, overshoots his intended receiver, Caleb Smith.
Great pocket presence in there by Leverett. Instead of flooding the pocket, which a lot of high school quarterbacks do, he saw that the pocket was collapsing. He stepped up into the pocket, then stepped to the right, just overthrew his receiver. I'm impressed by this Leverett kid out there.
The intended receiver was Caleb Smith. Smith actually has a couple of interceptions, I believe two in this ball game. And Smith is going to stay in the game. He'll be a receiver to the right of the quarterback, and now joining him there is Chevelle Smith and two receivers up top. Lone running back, Leverett back in the pocket, fires, pass in the hands and out of the hands. Once again, he had Chevelle Smith open, Ryan.
Well, Chevelle Smith is listed as a linebacker, and he had there's Caleb Smith and Chevelle Smith. That one knows Chevelle, he's a linebacker, so they have him out there at the receiver position. Maybe not something he's used to. He played his butt off at linebacker tonight, though. He played great out there defensively, and now they're trying to get him some touches offensively. What do you have, three plays?
I've got three plays remaining. The ball at the 20-yard line. The South, I'm sure, would like to score in one of these next three plays. They break the huddle. In the backfield, now they have Joel Evans, receivers left and right, and, of course, the quarterback still Dimitri Leverett for the South. He waits for the snap. Looks up and down, looks like he calls an audible, takes a low snap, bobbles a ball, screen pass, incomplete. Over to his right, he was trying to find Markel Jones. And
it's not a bad play call. Their defensive backs were way off, about 10, 15 yards of cushion between them and the wide receiver, so why not throw the screen play? They had Mordecai out here trying to make a stock block down the field. They just couldn't execute the screen play. He might have been off to the races if he completed that pass.
That may have been the final play of the game. Not sure. I had them down for one more play.
And that'll do it. You must have been wrong with your counting. But, again, that was the last final 10 plays. And these kids got some unbelievable reps. And unless the officials put the ball down somewhere else, it looks like they're going to shake hands at midfield and call it an evening. That was a great performance by the South team. And also some great kids for the North team that can really play. You look at the kid walking towards us right now for this North team with the green socks. We talked about him a few times. The linebacker, Jalen Nash, out of North Carolina, just one of the few players on the North team that'll play awesome tonight as well. So that'll do it for the juniors' practice. A good job for them to come away and get in the reps, and also, like we said, the senior game coming up as well.
There you see the North and the South team congratulating each other. As Ryan pointed out, perhaps a slight edge goes to this practice to the South, particularly Dimitri Leverett, their quarterback. Very fine player, did a little bit of everything, including quarterbacking a play or two for the North. Very generous of Leverett. The young men are all congratulating there at midfield. And then we'll break away in a few moments here on the National Underclassmen video that you're watching, live streaming from Myrtle Beach. And then we'll have the senior game coming up at 7 o'clock. Once again, that's going to wrap it up here for the junior practice at Dugshaw Stadium. Gary Griffith alongside Ryan Borowski. The juniors congratulating each other. We're about to wrap it up. And we'll see you at 7 o'clock for the senior game. That'll do it for me. Gary Griffith, thanks for listening.